I don't know.
Good morning, Mr. Brown.
Good morning. Thank you for waiting so quietly.
Good morning.
I appreciate that. I got to tell you something that happened last night. I had this incredible nightmare about math class. And I was lying in bed, and I dreamed that I was on Let's Make a Deal, this game show. And I was called out of the audience to go up. But when I got up, it wasn't in the audience. It was like in the cafeteria. That's where it was taking place. It wasn't at the regular place. So I got up there, and Monty Hall turned into Mason. And Mason was the game show host. And I got up there, and Mason says, okay, Mr. Brown, we understand you teach at Mariposa Elementary School. And up on stage, there are three curtains. There's a new car behind one of the curtains. Which one do you want to pick? And I said, okay, I'm ready to play Mason. I'll pick door number two. And he says, okay, before we show you behind door number two, we'll drop the curtain to door number three, or something like that. But anyway, they lowered the curtain that I didn't pick, one of the curtains I didn't pick, and there was a goat behind it, but it wasn't a goat, it was Tom Souza. And so Tom came out, and he started buying and stuff, and then Mason said, okay, you have two doors you haven't picked. Do you want to change your mind? And I was trying to think if there was any advantage to changing my mind, so I was there saying, I don't know, I don't know, I don't know, I don't know. And it was awful, because I woke up screaming. Well, anyway, after I screamed, I got this great idea to do something with math class today. So I brought in the newspaper, the Sun Telegram, which came out on Sunday, and in it is Parade magazine. How many of you have ever seen Parade? Okay. There's a column by Marilyn Savant, who is listed in the Guinness Hall of Fame for having the highest IQ, but I haven't been tested yet. But anyway, she writes this neat column where people write questions to her, and they're questions not only about math or physics, they're questions like about life and living, which I enjoy, you know, all the parts of it. But someone wrote in and said, if I were on a game show and I picked, and I had three doors to pick, and there were a car behind one of the doors and goats in the other two, and I picked one of the doors, and the game show host said, okay, you pick door number three, for example, we'll show you what's behind door number one. And he shows me door number one, and it's a goat. Is there any advantage to change? And she said, yes, there is. Well, most people thought that answer was crazy. They figured you have two doors left, you have a 50-50 chance of getting it right. So with either door, with staying or changing. So all these people wrote into the column from University of Michigan, Millikan University, University of Florida, Georgia State University, Georgetown University, Dickinson State University, Western State College, a lot of places saying, you're crazy. And basically she said, I stand by my answer. And she outlined a way to prove whether or not she was correct or incorrect. So we're going to try that today. But before we do that, I want to illustrate the problem. This is what occurred in my dream, three doors. And behind one of the doors is a new car. I'd like you to pick one of the doors. Robin.
Number two.
Okay, Robin picks door number two. But before I show you what's behind door number two, I'm going to show you what's behind door number three. And here we find a perfect likeness of a goat. There's a goat behind there. Now, do you want to change your mind? Is there any advantage to changing her mind right now and going back to door number one, or is it roughly the same probability? What I'd like for you to do is on the sheet of paper that I gave you, write down right now what you think your answer is. Is there an advantage to change, and why? Okay, go. Yesterday, I asked you to come up with an idea if you thought there was any advantage to changing doors. You've picked door number two, and the host said, I'll show you what's behind door number three, and there's a goat with a beard there. Is there now any advantage to change to door number one? And I asked you to write if you thought there was indeed an advantage. How many people thought your probability of winning was greater if you switched to number one? Did anybody think it was greater if you did that? How many of you think the chances are equal because the chances of it being behind one of those two is the same? Okay, a lot of people. Now, we want to try the experiment now, and I've given you the outline of how it should be conducted. You're going to do each way 200 times, and I'll let you work on it in teams of three. One of you should record, one of you should be the host, and one of you should be the contestant. If you want to trade off during that time, you're welcome to do that. So why don't we start? We'll split up into groups right now and see what you come up with your results and see if you change your mind. All right, let's go. What? That's easy. Sure. Okay. Okay. Everybody, smile and look at the camera because we're talking to her now. I don't know. I'll just pick somebody. I'll probably move the microphone around. Okay. Everybody, kind of quiet now. Smile. Here we go. Well, hi, Marilyn. We finally made it through our project. It took a few days, but I think we got there, and we had some very interesting results. How many of you thought the probability was about 50-50 of winning either way? And were any of you surprised to find out that it ended up being different?
Yeah. Yes.
What? Which did you win more often? In which case? When?
When you changed.
Okay. Why is that, do you think? Tatiana?
Because it's easier to pick a losing door because the probability is 2 out of 3 that you will pick the losing door.
Right. So we were very surprised about that. So next time we're on Game Show, we'll all know what to do, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, we had fun. We hope you enjoy our tape and our results, too. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
That's easy.
Bye.
That's
easy. That was easy. That's easy.